So you've decided to plan your website. Exciting times. It's the modern equivalent of building a brick and mortar storefront, complete with a pretty sign, well-organized shelves, and a friendly employee ready to ring customers up. Like building a physical store though, a shop layout and design that works for one business won't work for another. So planning your website requires a lot of thought before you start hanging all those metaphorical signs. While most videos out there about website layout focus on colors, fonts, and what looks good, we're looking at the whole picture. Because even though design matters, there's something even more important. Why you're designing it that way in the first place. But first, I'm Erin from SiteGround. And before we get started, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click the bell so you never miss any of our videos. Today, we'll walk through how to plan your site around your goals, your audience, and your brand, as well as talk about design. Because great design isn't just beautiful, it's intentional so that it can get the real job done. Let's start with your goals and audience. Before you can even start sketching a layout or picking colors, there's a big old step that often gets skipped. Yes, it's that of defining your goals and audience. This step is crucial for the development of your site because knowing what you want your website to do and who it's for guides every choice that follows. So first ask, what do you want your website to do? Are you trying to sell products, book appointments, grow an email list, share knowledge, or build authority in your niche? For example, if your goal is to sell products, your site design will focus on a smooth shopping experience with clear calls to action like buy now, along with easy product navigation. If you want to display images or showcase an artistic portfolio, your design will emphasize large visuals, clean layouts, and minimal distractions to let your work shine. Whatever your goal, your design should always guide users toward that main action. But knowing your goal is only half of the equation. You also need to know who you're building this for, your audience. Who are they? Think about demographics, age, location, profession. Are you talking to busy parents, tech professionals, or college students? What are their pain points and challenges? If you're offering a service, maybe they're frustrated with slow responses from other providers. If it's a product, maybe they're overwhelmed with choices and need guidance. Knowing this helps you shape your messaging and design choices to be solution-focused. Also, what are their goals when visiting your site? Think about what your audience is actually trying to do. Are they ready to buy? Just browsing, comparing options? Your job is to meet them where they are and guide them toward the next step in the customer journey. We've actually got a really important and, dare I say, essential video about this. I'll leave the link below because it's just so very critical to understand all the stages your audience goes through in their journey with your brand. Because whether their final destination is a purchase, a sign-up, more views, or simply deeper engagement, there's a funnel at play, even if you're not technically selling something. Grasping this will vastly help you plan your website and what it needs to accomplish to meet your audience where they're at. Site structure. With your goals and audience in mind, it's now time to start planning a few foundational essentials, starting with the site structure. Think of this step like organizing a house. You want everything in the right room and easy to find. The first step is to identify core pages, your homepage, about page, contact page, plus any specific pages for your business, like services, products, or a portfolio. These are the rooms your visitors need to see, and we'll cover these pages more in depth in a moment. Now let's build your sitemap. Your homepage is the front door, and everything else branches off from there. Main sections like about, services, and contact should be one click away. Subpages go beneath them, like rooms off a hallway. This helps both your visitors and search engines make sense of your site. With that in mind, group related pages into neat little sections. If you've got 5 services, don't make them fight for attention. Tuck them under a clean services menu. As you can see, the beauty of this is that once you know the pages you'll need, it's all super easy to build out with a user-friendly site builder. Like, say, for example, SiteGround website builder. Just add your pages, choose a template, fill in the content with our handy built-in AI text generator and library of free-to-use images, and you're on your way. As you build out your site, it's also important to remember to prioritize what matters. Some pages are more important than others. If booking a call or signing up for your newsletter is the goal, don't bury it. Make it super easy to find, preferably in your main navigation or as a bold call to action. And finally, plan for the future. Your website should be able to grow with your business, so leave room to add new pages or features later without needing to do a full makeover. Branding. Just like your sitemap, this too is going to set the stage for all your coming website planning. because even if your site layout and content are super duper dialed, it will all fall flat without solid branding to bolster it. You might already have a logo, and hey, that's a great start, but now's the time to zoom out and tighten up your entire brand identity. This is what makes your website instantly recognizable and totally on brand, from the fonts to the feels. Let's break it down. Logo. Whether you already have one or not, remember to keep that logo simple, memorable, and something that speaks to your values. After all, it's the heart and soul of your brand. Color scheme. Make sure to identify your primary palette, that is, your go-to shades, as well as some secondary colors that you can use for elements like links and buttons. Typography. Choose fonts that reflect your brand style. One for headlines and one for body text usually does the trick. Google Fonts is a great place to start, plus they're free to use. Tone of voice. Is your business's vibe warm and friendly, bold and authoritative, quirky and fun? Whatever it is, own it and use that same tone across your copy. Visual style. Clean and minimal, bright and energetic, nail down the vibe you're going for. It'll help guide everything from layout to imagery. Pull all these pieces together and keep them consistent, because whether you're designing the homepage or writing a product description, your brand should feel cohesive and recognizable. And just like building your site structure, implementing this part is super simple to do. With the SiteGround website builder, you just go to styles and set your desired colors, fonts, and shapes so that your brand comes to life across your website. Oh, and last important tip on this, jot all this down. Having brand guidelines, however informal, will save you and any designers you work with a ton of time and heartache down the road. Homepage. Now time for the star of the show, your homepage. This is often your website's first impression. And while first impressions matter, an awful lot, visitors decide in just a few seconds whether they'll stay and explore or move on to another option, like say your competitor. That means your homepage really needs to pull off quite the balancing act. Be visually appealing, clearly explain who you are and what you do, and guide users toward taking action. And it all needs to happen super fast. No pressure, right? That's why your homepage isn't just another page. It's the page. It deserves extra attention and strategy to make sure you're not only grabbing attention, but also keeping it. So what makes a homepage truly great? We go deep into this in our full video on homepage design. Seriously, it's worth the watch. The link's below. But here are a few quick takeaways to keep in mind. Make the hero section count. This is the top of your homepage, your prime real estate. Use it to clearly say what you offer, who it's for, and why it matters. Keep the text concise, the visuals on brand, and don't forget a strong call to action. Guide the user. Don't make people guess what to do next. Use prominent calls to action throughout the page and intuitive navigation to gently steer them in the right direction. Use social proof. Show that others love what you do. Testimonials, press mentions, user-generated content, these add instant credibility and reassurance. Keep it light and fast. A slow homepage can kill the entire experience. Optimize your images, trim the fluff, and make sure your site loads quickly, something made much more possible if you use a good hosting provider, like, you know, SiteGround. In fact, you can easily cross all of the previously mentioned items off your list in one fell swoop with the help of the SiteGround website builder. It makes building a website gloriously easy and fun, all while providing you with all the top-notch performance, security, and reliability that SiteGround is known for. I'll leave a link below so you can get started. Secondary pages. What about secondary pages? You know, about, services, contact, and maybe FAQs. These pages aren't meant to wow in the same way your homepage does, but they're just as important when it comes to delivering clarity and moving your customers along to conversion. In terms of design, here's the golden rule. Keep those secondary pages simpler, but keep them consistent. That means stick with your established branding. So the same fonts, colors, and tone of voice. Use a consistent layout or template, like the same header or page title style across each one. And lastly, simplify the structure. Because these pages are often where visitors look for specifics, the focus should be on readability and easy navigation, not on trying to ooh and ah. In other words, let your homepage be the star and the second pages the support. You want them to feel like a part of the same story, just told with fewer fireworks. Oh, and I should mention, if you're feeling a little overwhelmed with the idea of coming up with all this content, then I've got the resource for you. I did a whole video on creating your site with the help of ChatGPT. It will make your website planning process shockingly easy. Check it out in the links below. Other elements to plan for. At this point, you might be thinking, okay, I've got a homepage, a few solid secondary pages. We're good to go, right? Hit publish and hello world. Yeah, you could stop there. But if you really want your website to do more than just look pretty, you know, like bring in leads, grow your audience, and help your business thrive, then there are a few more things you should plan for. First, add a newsletter signup form. If you're not building an email list, now's the time to start. Email marketing still delivers one of the highest ROIs out there. And since you've already done the work to bring someone to your website, don't let them leave without giving them an easy way to stay in touch. Not sure how best to do this? Or are you new to the world of email marketing? No problem. We've got a video for that too. The link is below. Track your metrics. Don't just build it and forget it. Use your analytics to understand how your site is performing. If people are leaving after the homepage, maybe your call to action needs work. If they're getting to your contact page but not reaching out, maybe your form feels too cold or isn't functioning properly. Metrics give you insight, and insight lets you improve. We've got a video for this too. You know where to find that link. I should also mention that we at SiteGround happen to be experts on email marketing that is super user-friendly and effective. Easily build and segment your list and start sending emails straight away thanks to ready-to-use templates and a built-in AI editor. I'll leave a link to SiteGround email marketing below. And there you have it, your website planning toolkit, fully stocked and ready to go. If you're launching something new or giving your new site a much-needed glow-up, thoughtful planning today will help you avoid major headaches tomorrow. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more tips, and don't forget to ring that bell so you never miss a video. And if you're still piecing things together, check out the links below for more deep dives, from homepage strategy to ChatGPT content hacks to email marketing basics. See you next time.